Los Angeles-based Jungo TV recently launched a Pinoy entertainment app, that's Jungo Pinoy, which streams specifically created and curated content for Filipino viewers. For more on this, Jungo TV co-founder and CEO George Chung joins us this morning. George, welcome to Market Edge.
Thank you, Mimi. Pleasure to be here.
Did I say that right? Jungo TV?
Yes, it's actually pronounced Jungo, just like welcome to the Jungo.
Oh, I see. So I guess that's the reason behind the name then. It's a jungle of streaming services. Is that it? Or is there a different reason?
Believe it or not, it's a Latin word that actually means to come together or to unite. And it was the original reason we created the service, so we could bring different types of content from different places around the world, thus uniting content from around the world everywhere.
All right, so why don't you walk us through, George, your business model? You are a streaming app. I understand your niche, and you're not really going up against giant platforms like Netflix or Disney or HBO Max, or are you?
That's a great question. And no, we're not going up against some of those major names that you just mentioned. Really, the big difference between Jungo and really all the other apps that are in the world is we focus on international content, international programming that we curate specifically for the Filipino audience. And my team, as well as myself, have had extensive experience working in the Philippines, understanding the audience, the culture, the likes, the dislikes. From the time of that we first launched in the Philippines, launching first in social media, we've been able to gain really great insights on what the market likes. So what we do is we focus on niche content such as independent horror films, action movies, martial arts, esports, K-pop, things that your Disney's, your HBO's, your other streaming services aren't really going to focus on. Rather, they're going to focus on taking their American content and really pushing it out in the Philippines. We take our content, even if it's produced in America, and we completely dub it in Tagalog, thus creating a very local soundtrack for our audiences. And we found that by dubbing the content in local language, that our content from a consumption standpoint can go up as much as 10 times versus just subtitling or putting it in English, just as English soundtrack.
All right, so George, will you be creating content, original content, or you're just gonna be collating from different production houses, even networks here in the Philippines?
Right. So actually, we do create our own content, and we create quite a lot of content. And that will range everywhere from music programming to sports, concerts, as well as our own motion pictures. This year, we've already produced 2 motion pictures, and we have a significant slate that we'll be producing over the next year that will include production in the Philippines as well, focusing again on the markets that we know best, which are action and horror.
You launched 2 original production movies this year. Can we get the titles of those 2 movies?
Yes, of course. Of course. And we actually have already released them in Tagalog language. The first is called Lost Souls, which is an independent horror film. And the second one is called Hen Night, which is, again, another horror film. And we're very proud of the fact that we're able to produce at such a fast volume. We're able to do this because, again, we understand the market really well, what the audience likes. You might not know the name Jungo in the Philippines, but you might know our products. So although Jungo Pinoy is new to the Philippines, what is not new are the services that we've been running for the past few years. Our most successful is our YouTube channel called Tagalove, which currently sees anywhere between 50 and 70 million viewers a month. Again, we started with that platform on YouTube, creating a Tagalog dub soundtrack for all of our movies that we presented, and really found a great understanding of what the audience liked. From there, we actually moved into digital terrestrial channels with a partnership with GMA, with a channel called Hollypop, which many of your viewers that live in the Metro Manila area might know through Affordabox. We're actually on digital terrestrial, as well as we operate now 3 cable channels with our partners Solar Entertainment, which are Front Row, ScreenFlix, and Toro TV.
I know that you also have a partnership with TFC channel, right? Of the ABS-CBN.
That is correct. Yeah, that's very exciting because we recently launched some of our channels on iWantTV, and we're very excited about this partnership.
Okay, it looks great. So you're going to be producing original content. What's the mix, though, when you look in the next 3 to 5 years? Is it going to be 50-50, 50% original content, 50% content you buy from other producers?
I think it'll be more closer to 80-20, 80% of content that we license and localize and 20% of content that we make. Now you have to understand, though, when we release content, our schedule is much greater than most services. We will release on an average of one new movie a day at minimum. That's over 300 movies a year. So imagine that if we're producing at least 20% of that, that means our slate can go 50, 60 movies a year that we're actually producing. So it's quite a lot of content that will be original from Jungo.
And Jungo, you also serve other markets outside of the Philippines, right? Which are
that's
the other
correct,
big markets?
Yeah, so the other markets that we serve are Latin America in with our Spanish, Brazil with our Portuguese content, but we have a very strong Filipino diaspora as well. So we're servicing through our YouTube networks and our social media platforms in the Middle East, the UK, Canada, and of course in the United States where we reside.
All right. I was going over your website and you did share some numbers there, 2 billion monthly views, 300 million active users. That's pretty sizable market share. I mean, when you look at Netflix, Netflix just had 221 million subscribers.
Yeah, so remember, we started our business because, you know, you when you look at the business models and where I think most of streaming services fail is in the fact that most streaming services fail not on content and not necessarily on operations, but it's subscriber acquisition costs. As you know, whether you're Netflix or Amazon or HBO, there's a tremendous cost of acquisition. It could go into a two-figure US dollars, you know, it can go $5, $10, $20 in some cases. Where we are very different is that we anticipated that we would eventually launch our own product and service with the bespoke Jungo product, Jungo Pinoy. However, we knew that in order to do that, we had to mitigate our costs in marketing. And this is why that we started our YouTube and our social media platforms. So although our numbers are really high, they obviously, they're still served on YouTube, but these are our channels that we own and operate on YouTube. Now, what that does, it helps us with a lot of data and insight of what people are consuming, what people are looking at. And so we're very proud of the numbers that, that we have. As I said, in the Philippines alone, you know, we're servicing 50 to 70 million views a month, you know, and we're talking about hundreds of millions of minutes per user, per country that we're serving. And when you add all that up, it comes over 2 billion minutes a month that people are consuming of Jungo content. So again, that gives us great insight and great confidence as we go into the markets because we're already seeing what the consumer likes.
All right, let's talk about the consumer then. I'm curious what you're seeing. I mean, there's just so much competition for viewers' demand and the time that they have out there. I mean, even Netflix saw demand for content evaporate post-pandemic, whether it's, you know, consumers or viewers shifting to competition or people just watching less because they need to go back out there with economies reopening. What visibility are you getting right now?
Well, that's a great question. And I think one of the differences, again, because when you look at Jungo compared to other companies, we are not a company in LA that looks to service companies overseas by saying we're going to open up the market digitally with a stroke of a computer keyboard. No, we actually have boots on the ground. In fact, we have a huge team in Manila and my own team here in Los Angeles. Many of my senior members of my executive team actually came from the largest Filipino broadcasters, including ABS-CBN, which gives us tremendous insight of what the market wants. I think what's important for people to understand when you look at content, there's a word that I will bring that you will very rarely hear a CEO talk about when they talk about streaming media.
All right.
And that word is respect. I respect the culture of the Philippines. I've spent many, many years. In fact, prior to my media career, I started my career off as a professional athlete in martial arts. My background and roots actually started, believe it or not, with Filipino martial arts as a young child. I actually have spent many, many years traveling back and forth to the Philippines, have honed great friendships. In fact, some of our relationships we have with Jungo TV, for example, Solar Entertainment, Wilson Ting, who runs Solar, I've had a relationship with Wilson now going on over 35 years mm-hmm. of doing business with him. So having that type of knowledge of what's going on the ground is really important, but respecting the culture of what the culture likes, how things change. I mean, here's the one thing. You can look at most of your streaming platforms, whether they're HBO or Amazon or Netflix, and I guarantee they couldn't tell you what the traffic is between Makati and Quezon City on EDSAT 5 in the afternoon. We know what that traffic's like.
All right.
So having that understanding, I think, is really important because we understand the amount of time people spend in commute traffic, the time that they have that is precious to stream, the cost of data in the Philippines, mm-hmm. it's so important. How people measure that, all of these things we take into consideration when we put out content.
All right, it's one thing to be able to tailor fit content for a specific market like the Philippines. It's another to be affordable. I guess my question is, what are some of the pricing challenges? You can't get too expensive because there's just too many options out there. So how are you in terms of pricing? How competitive are you? On a monthly basis, for example, give us an idea. If I download the app today, how much will I have to shell out every month?
Let's start with this number, okay? How about free? Zero. We actually start most of our people off in an AVOD environment because we know that there's going to be an adoption rate. So we have mm-hmm. to get people to watch our content before they're going to pay for our content. I actually came from the streaming business from a very successful model, which was a company called Crunchyroll, which was really is the leader of anime content. The one thing I learned when I was at Crunchyroll, in order to get your paid subscribers, you had to have free subscribers.
Okay.
In Jungo, we are one of the few services in the Philippines that will risk putting our content out in an ad-supported environment.
Because we know there you go. So there will be ads. Absolutely,
there'll be ads. But we know through our experience with YouTube that the consumers, obviously, are watching millions and millions of hours of content already, are watching the ads. Actually, it's a much better experience on the Jungo Pinoy app because there is actually less ads, and the environment versus YouTube is much nicer in a viewing environment. And with our partnership with Dito today, you're actually able to get very low costs, you know, anywhere between weekly plans that go, I think, as low as 19 pesos a month to monthly plans that go under 99 pesos a month for that. So it's really important that we keep the prices very low, but it also give the people an entry point to get on.
George, I'm going to have to push you a little bit. Zero free for how long?
As long as you're watching it.
As long as you're watching. Yeah, because exactly, because the model is the ads. You know what they say? When
That's
something
correct.
Is free, you're usually the product, so it's the ads. But will you be creating models where there are tiers that eventually your viewers will have the option to upgrade to another price point, which is no longer free, but skip the ads?
Absolutely.
Pretty much like what YouTube does. Is that the plan?
Absolutely, because in order for us to, again, we know the business model so well because we've been so successful mm-hmm. in the Philippines with our YouTube model. We know that the people there, the majority of the people, will always watch for free. We know that. So, but in order to capture a mm-hmm. market of paid subscribers, you have to have that user base of
Correct.
Free subscribers. We're not mm-hmm. going to kid ourselves just to think, hey, we're going to launch in the market and suddenly mm-hmm. everyone's going to join.
Mm-hmm. All right. Speaking of YouTube, YouTube gave rise to, content creators. I'm very curious, is this something that Jungo TV is also looking at, putting out their fresh content from social media stars? Can I just share, George, I was fascinated to find out that Coco Melon, which is a YouTube hit, was the number two streamed show on Netflix last year. Just a little mm-hmm. behind Criminal Minds. But Coco Melon is it's based on a social media storytelling. It was able to unlock social commerce opportunities. What about for you? Are you seeing opportunities in creating or using, content created by, social media influencers or stars to be put on your platform? Is that something that you think is doable?
I think when it comes to what we're doing at Jungo, we're really focusing on motion picture content, really has pretty much 80% of the content that we have. And again, we're able to understand what the viewer wants because of all the data that we're seeing on YouTube of the type of movies, how long they're watching. So I think it's really important that we focus on what we do best.
All right. And on that note, George, thank you so much for joining us. Good luck.
We're
looking
so
forward
much.
To getting more good news from Jungo TV. Welcome to the Jungo.
Thank you. Welcome to the Jungo.
All right.